everyone, my name is Weijia. Today I'm going to give a stock pitch about Walt Disney Company and illustrate why, although their stock recently is performing really well, it should be considered as a sell in the future. The presentation will be divided into four parts. Firstly, I will introduce the Walt Disney Company, then I will give the industry overview, after that I will show my evaluation of the stock price, and lastly, I will give my own suggestion of future stock investment. Walt Disney Company is an American diversified multinational firm focusing on mass media and entertainment. It was first founded in 1923 by Walt Disney. In 1928, the Mickey Mouse, the most successful cartoon character in history and the basis for the massive empire of Disney World, was developed. In 1937, Walt Disney released its first film, Snow White and the Seven Dwarfs. In 1940, Walt Disney Company went public and the stock price at IPO after 17 years was 13.88. In 1955, the first Disneyland was opened after so many years of dreaming and planning, and the first Disney store opened following in 1987. All of this make Walt Disney today is a profitable and valuable company with four main business segments: media networks, parks and resorts, studio entertainment, and consumer products and interactive entertainment. In the fiscal year of 2019, the largest amount of revenue comes from its parks and resorts segment, and the largest profits comes from media and networks. However, consumer products and interactive entertainment was not profitable at all and lost $1.81 billion operating income, which sluggish the growth opportunity of the whole company. In last 12 months, Disney stock price earned 28% and now trading around $145. There were two huge upsurge with its streaming service, Disney Plus. In April, Disney stock increased 18% after the Disney Plus updates that several analysts expect that the streaming service will have 16 million to 90 million subscribers. Disney Company has continued to spend more money and take a big bet on this streaming service. In November, Disney Company launched the Disney Plus to the market successfully, resulting the stock price jumped to $150. Overall, with the high potential of this new streaming service, it seems that Disney stock is really attractive to buy. However, investors should take a deep look before recklessly investing in Disney. Disney stock lies in the communication sector. According to Charles Schwab, because of the road to fifth generation cellular wireless technology, the cost of communication service companies is likely to grow, and many companies now face risks that outweigh their potential rewards, leading to the underperformance of the whole sector. What's more, Deloitte predicts that the streaming war will intensify in media and entertainment industry in 2020. Almost all major US TV networks and studios will have a standalone direct-to-consumer streaming service by mid-2020. As a result, many US consumers are growing frustrated with having to manage and pay for multiple subscriptions to watch what they want. What's more, for the whole market, the yield curve was firstly inverted in August and stayed inverted since October. The economists predict that the probability of recession in 2020 ranges from 20% to 55%. If the recession happened, it would directly harm the entertainment industry and affect Disney's business. Thus, Disney is in a high-risk sector, an industry with hyper-competition, and the market with lots of uncertainty. To evaluate Disney's value, the comparable companies which have similar business and company structures as Disney's were founded and listed here. The top five comps from FactSet named by Hoover's includes Discovery, Comcast, Viacom, CBS, Qurate Retail, and AMC Entertainment, giving an average of 9.95 EBITDA multiple, while Walt Disney Company has a much higher multiple of 20.32. illustrating that its stock is probably a little bit overvalued by the market right now. To make the evaluation more precious, I found the top comps from Bloomberg as well. Bloomberg generates more similar comparable companies, giving the higher average EBITDA multiple of 14.3. By comparing Walt Disney's own EBITDA multiple and the average of the comps suggested by FactSet and Bloomberg, I decided to apply the Bloomberg's average because Walt Disney's EBITDA multiple is too high and Bloomberg's is the closest one. By multiplying the EBITDA multiple to Walt Disney's first year forecast EBITDA, we could get the company's enterprise value. After adding back cash item and subtract debt, and then divided by shares outstanding, the implied Disney stock valuation is about 118, which is 20% lower than its current stock price, suggesting that the Disney stock is overvalued right now and would potentially down to 118. Thus, if the EBITDA multiple of Disney will move back to industry average, it's a great chance to sell the stock now and gain 20% of return. Besides the relative valuation model, I also applied the discounted cash flow model to reach an implied stock price. Firstly, I evaluated the weighted average cost of capital, the WACC, of Walt Disney Company. The capital structure of the company, the risk-free rate, and US market premium is funded from the Bloomberg. I chose 10-year monthly beta because I perceive the probability of the near recession is really high. So I want to use beta that includes the longer time period with different economic conditions. I use the debt adjustment factor of 1.29 since most Disney's debt locates in a range of credit rating system. I use the 21% as an effective tax rate since the forecasted tax rate would be around 21% as the current government set corporate tax. I don't expect tax will change so much in the future. Blending this all together, it gives the Disney cost of capital of 8.04%. Then I created the basic assumptions of the DCF model. The increase in working capital over sales was the average of past 4 years. Capital expenditure to sales and depreciation to capital expenditure as average of future 5 years forecast. I also set the terminal growth rate of 3% because I don't expect Disney to be a company with high growth potential since its PE ratio is just the average of the comparable companies. Then I apply the forecasted 5 years average of revenue growth of 8%, EBITDA margin of 24%, and EBIT margin of 20% to the model to predict the company's free cash flows. The DCF model is shown as follows. By using 5 years planning period and the terminal growth rate of 3%, the enterprise value of Walt Disney Corporation is about $0.28 billion, and its estimated stock price is 129.33, which is still lower than the current market price. The stock would potentially go down by 12% in the future. Investors should grasp the chance to sell the stock and gain the potential return of 12%. Both the APV model and the DCF model suggest that Disney stock is currently overvalued by the market and investors should pursue a sell strategy since the price will adjust it down. Besides these two models, the potential recession in the near future will reasonably drive down the whole market stock price. Thirdly, the financial statement shows that the company is not performing as well as its stocks reflect recently. We could see that the sales growth in the most recent quarter is really high, but it would be one-time growth. The 5 years average forecast drives the revenue growth back to the normal level. What's more, the EBITDA margin and EBIT margin currently is much lower than the historical average, meaning that the company spent more to capture the revenue growth. The return on assets and the return on equity will drastically drop down in the future, suggesting there will be some issues for asset management and capital structure of the company. Last but not least, the release of Disney Plus is a main reason of the recent stock boom of Walt Disney Company. However, the Disney Plus is not expected to be profitable for Walt Disney for 5 years. Based on the four reasons mentioned above, I myself suggest investors to sell Walt Disney stock. Rather than buying Disney stock for the entertainment industry, why not considering Live Nation Entertainment? Live Nation Entertainment is a company that sets up the music shows and then sells the tickets. It's currently trading at $69. However, this stock has so much potential in the future. As the younger generation is more into music, the music industry is expected to double in size and reach $130 billion market size in 2030. While live music is a crucial position, about $40 billion market size. The company itself has 570 million fans all over the world, and over the last 3 years, the events the company hosts increased by 33%. With the growing industry and the large size of customer base, Live Nation Entertainment is considered as an attractive corporation and a good investment. Okay, that's that's all my presentation about why Disney stock should be a sell. Thank you for listening, and here is my reference list. Thanks so much.